chapter 35 of Mansfield Park, Edmund joins Fanny on her daily walk and presses her to reveal her feelings. Fanny's comforted because Edmund agrees she's responded appropriately to Henry's proposal. If she cannot love Henry, she shouldn't marry him. To her dismay, he says if she learns to love Henry, she will prove herself the perfect model of a woman. Fanny says she can never, never, never love Henry, and tells him Henry's behavior toward Mariah, Rushworth, and Julia, and during the theatricals, reveals his dishonorable nature. Edmund excuses Henry and blames the theatricals and his sisters of having encouraged Henry's flirtations. Plus, Mary worries about Henry's happiness. She's angry that Fanny has refused her brother. Edmund changes the subject, and Fanny is so downcast by this point that Edmund leads her back to the house. In chapter 36, Edmund assures Sir Thomas that Fanny simply needs time to adjust to the idea of Henry loving her and gets his father's agreement to leave Fanny alone. Meanwhile, Fanny waits anxiously for Mary's visit, and when she arrives, agrees by her habits of ready submission to speak in the East Room. There, taken aback by Mary's real affection for Edmund and the whole family, Fanny embraces Mary tearfully. Mary now regrets having to leave Mansfield Park and laments the unhappy marriages some of her friends have made as she tries to talk up Henry. Mary admits the gift of the necklace was Henry's idea, a ploy to get Fanny to accept from Mary what she would never accept from Henry. Mary insists that Henry's love for Fanny is real and lasting and offers William's promotion as evidence, hitting on the one fact Fanny cannot refute. The women embrace and Mary leaves. Chapter 35 is a low point in Fanny's young life because Edmund, her beloved cousin and counselor, lets her down badly. In a sense, he redefines their relationship as he joins everyone else in urging her to marry Henry. The chapter ends as Edmund shepherds his exhausted cousin to the house with the kind authority of a privileged guardian, yet another surrogate parent who assumes to know Fanny's mind better than she does. Mary agrees that Henry is a sad flirt, but Fanny will convert him into a good man. His efforts on William's behalf, which seem more manipulative every time someone mentions them, are proof of that.